Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. In the United States alone, 22 people die every day waiting for a kidney, liver, heart, or lung transplant. There simply aren't enough donated human organs to go around, and we can't just go around stealing them out of random healthy people. But pigs' organs have roughly the same structure and proportions as human organs, and we already kill 500 million of the creatures every year for food. So why can't we just use their organs? Here's the thing. Our immune systems are really, really good at seeking out and destroying anything foreign to our bodies. So even human-to-human organ transplants sometimes get rejected. And pig organs are much foreigner. They have a super conspicuous sugar molecule on the surface of their cells that's basically a fight me sign for humans' organ-rejecting antibodies. But we've actually been able to engineer pigs whose organs don't carry those sugars. So, assuming we could take care of pig organs' other fight-me signs in similar ways, we might one day be able to transplant pig organs into humans. But there's a far more radical idea for pork-based organ farming. Grow customized human organs in pigs. Actually, it's not just an idea. It's an ongoing experiment in real life. First, we engineer a pig embryo that doesn't grow its own kidneys. Then we inject it with stem cells from the person needing a transplant. Then, as the modified pig embryo develops, those human cells grow inside the incubator into healthy kidneys made from the patient's own cells. At least, that's the plan. So far, we've only seen this experiment all the way through when the modified pig embryos were injected with stem cells from other pigs. We don't know whether it'll actually work with human kidneys, because we've halted all experiments with the pig-human embryos after just 4 weeks of development, because some of those human stem cells could develop into other human organs elsewhere in the pig's body, which raises a lot of ethical questions, like what to do with them. Even if the cells don't migrate and these hybrid pigs end up producing lots of life-saving organs, what rights do we give to a part human pig, even if the part is just a kidney? What if it's two kidneys? Two kidneys, a liver, and a set of lungs? In principle, we could use the same technology to grow human hearts, human spinal cords, and even human brains all inside of a pig. And when we do, how will we know if that pig is still a pig? This episode of MinuteEarth is sponsored in part by Tab for a Cause. If you're like me, you open a lot of tabs in your browser. Tab for a Cause is a browser extension that donates to charity with each new tab you open, which means lots of money for nonprofits like Conservation International and Human Rights Watch without costing you a thing. The last time we featured Tab for a Cause, Minute Earthlings like you raised more than $10,000. Click the link in the description to help us do even better this time. And while you're down there, will you find the notification bell next to the subscribe button and click on it? YouTube has changed how it notifies subscribers, and this is the best way to make sure you find out when we post a new video. You can do the same thing on your phone or tablet. If you don't see the bell, make sure you're subscribed in the first place. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.